makes history.
Yeah.
Manchester, I say to you, thank you for allowing a 65-year-old man to come. And to say goodbye to you, and I thank you. Thank you very much. Let's just do 2 out of 3 and down, okay? Hang on just for 1 second. What did you just say to me?
I said,
yes.
We're going to go.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
took it into your heart. You took it into your soul. You felt it with great passion. You felt it the same way that Jim Steinman and myself felt it. As we worked on it, Jim and I became more and more passionate about it. But nobody understood us until Mr. Todd Rundgren showed up. And Todd Rundgren, I can't tell you how many producers and different people that we sang live for. And we didn't do demos because it's impossible to demo these. We sang live with piano and vocal, and Ellen came along sometimes. And Todd Rundgren listened to it, and he went, "Oh, I know how to do this." And Jim and I were stunned. He said, let's start on this in 3 weeks. Just come up to Bearsville. So we did. The end of October of 1975, we went to Bearsville and we started Bad to Hell. And you've all taken it to your heart and you've loved it. And what I'm going to say and what I'm going to say to you now is that this record no longer belongs to Jim Steinman and me. It is your record. It belongs to you. And this is the true story. I have never once asked Jim what he wrote about, why he wrote it, what he meant by it, because I didn't want it to interfere with my feelings for it. That's the same reason that in any interview that I've ever given, I've never given why I sing a song a certain way, because I didn't want to interfere with your dreams and your visions. That's why it belongs to you. I will say this. This side of the road, people had great passion and love for it. On the other side of the road, don't say anything yet. That side of the road over there, they hated it. But they, I don't bump them, because they hated it with passion. And that was the object of the exercise, to bring the passion out in the people. So if you loved it or you hated it, we didn't really care, because you did it with passion. And anything that you ever decide to do in life, do it with passion. I have been trying now for a good, minute and a half to avoid talking about this song. I knew eventually I had to. This song was written in 1969, 44 years ago, when Jim was at Amherst College. And right about now, right about at this very moment, while we're sitting and standing here in Manchester, Amherst is awarding Jim a doctorate degree tonight. As I am of Jim Steinman. The industry finally recognized him and voted him into the Songwriters Hall of Fame last year. Amherst College is giving him a doctor's degree tonight. You know why? Because Jim is a master. And every master has his masterpiece. And this is Jim Steinman's masterpiece. Song 40 years ago. He said to me, "Let me play you this song and see if you think it should be on Bad Outta Hell." He already had the name of the record. We didn't have the song, but he had the name of the record. And so he started to play it for me. And by the time he got to the sixth line, I started to cry. And normally, when Jimmy plays me a song or tells me lyrics over the phone, which he did just about 2 weeks ago, and it's 14, the song can't take the title. But Jimmy and I will be back in the studio in January and February. And on one of the songs we're doing, Ellen Foley, Carla DeVito, and Patty Russo. It's 14 minutes long. I think that's long enough for four people to sing, don't you? He played me crying out loud, and I began to cry. It's the only time he's made me cry. It's because it's the greatest love song that has ever been written, and I've been looking for 40 years to try to find a better one, and one does not exist. So if you're having a wedding, and you're going to propose, take 10 minutes, play this song before you say, "Will you marry me?" Trust me, she'll be crying. Or if it's the other way around, he'll be crying. Okay. I was lost. me the answers when I'm asking you why.
Love.
Hallelujah.